Good morning. We've already talked a lot about the buoyant force. Today we are going to look at a classic buoyancy question.
Flippin' physics.
Bobby, please read the problem, and Billy, please translate.
A chunk of ice floats in a glass of water. As the ice melts, does the water level in the glass go up, down, or remain the same?
Do we really have zero known values?
We know the density of ice is less than the density of water, which is why ice floats on water.
Okay, is that it then?
Yeah. I think the water level goes up.
Well, I think the water level goes down.
Well, I think you are both just guessing and we should actually solve the problem instead.
Sure.
Yeah.
But how?
I think we start with the free body diagram of the forces acting on the chunk of ice and go from there.
Yeah.
Okay, the buoyant force is up and the force of gravity is down. That means the net force in the y direction equals buoyant force minus force of gravity. And net force equals mass of the object, or the chunk of ice, times acceleration in the y direction.
And the ice is not moving, so the acceleration of the ice in the y direction equals zero. That means the buoyant force equals the force of gravity, and we can substitute in equations for that. The mass of the fluid displaced by the chunk of ice times gravitational field strength equals the mass of the object times gravitational field strength. And
everybody brought gravitational field strength to the party!
Everybody brought mass.
That means the mass of the fluid displaced by the ice chunk equals the mass of the ice chunk. And we know density equals mass over volume, so mass equals density times volume. We can substitute that into our equation to get the density of the fluid displaced by the ice chunk times the volume of the fluid displaced by the ice chunk equals the mass of the ice chunk. I feel like we're right near the answer.
Yeah.
We are. Let's start by isolating the chunk of ice in the water and removing it from the glass. And let's add a glass of just water to our picture. In order to get an equal mass amount of water, we need to isolate a volume of water which has the volume of the fluid displaced by the object. And that is the volume of the chunk of ice which is below the water line in the glass. So let's remove that from the glass of water. To reiterate, this chunk of ice and this volume of water have the same mass. As the ice melts, it becomes water, and the volume of the water fills the space below the waterline where the chunk of ice used to be. So replacing the chunk of ice with an equal mass of water means the water level will stay the same. And you can see that's exactly what happens in this video, which is half real speed video and half time lapse.
Oh, I get it. If we were to remove the chunk of ice and replace it with water, because the density of the substance increases as it changes from ice to water, the volume of the water we would need to use would equal the empty space below the waterline, where the chunk of ice used to be. Therefore, the water level stays the same as the ice melts.
Yeah, that's what Mr. P just said.
Yeah, but I added the part about the density of the substance increasing as it goes from ice to water.
Yeah.
Well, you look at that. The physics works.
Oh, yeah.
The physics works. The physics works. The physics works. The physics works. The physics works.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.